It was a busy time for the railway, as business and expansion rose spectacularly. Goods and passengers were being transported all over from the bustling cities to the beautiful countryside. The engines had to work harder than ever to accommodate the heavy workload. It seemed as soon as they were finished with one train, they were needed to take out another. Despite all their efforts, it was clear another engine was needed to run the main line. The manager visited his engines and told them to wait for a new engine that would be arriving soon for freight duty. The diesels were especially excited, because steam engines were hard to come by, and that meant that a new diesel would arrive to the line. They waited impatiently for the arrival of the newcomer. Not long afterward, the new engine arrived. He was a medium-sized 462 steam engine who was white in the face with Canadian National written upon his tender. He rolled triumphantly before Calvin, Hobbs, Seth, and Kick-Sass. The manager introduced him. "I'd like you all to meet our new engine, Lumberjack. He used to work on a major logging line in Canada until it closed down. He's notorious for the long, heavy trains he's tackled. Now that we've found work for him here, I'm sure he'll prove very useful, and I count on that you will all give him a warm welcome." The diesels glared. They did not expect another steam engine to join them. Kick-Sass and Rockstar were some of the few engines they had to deal with. Although they didn't have a grudge for steam engines, Seth, the electric diesel engine, devised a plan to get a kick out of the rest of the diesels. He was going to play a trick on Lumberjack. The diesels watched Lumberjack all day as he did his work. He seemed a simple sort of engine that was far too comfortable with his position on the line. This observation manifested itself into an awful grudge. The diesels agreed something must be done to put the newcomer in his place. The mainline freight was considered to be the turf of the diesels. As he learned the ropes, he got along with all the steam engines, and they all welcomed him with open arms. As Lumberjack was preparing to depart for the yard, the diesels stopped him at the station. "Hello, my friend," said Calvin. "We welcome you to our railway, Lumberjack." "Yes, indeed," said Bolt. "We hope you enjoy your stay here. However, you have a certain test that you must complete before you become one of us." "A test, eh?" smiled Lumberjack. The diesels interpreted his calmness as cockiness, but in reality, he was a rather decent sort of engine. "Yes," grinned Seth. "When you finish your work, meet us in the marshalling yard. There you will find your initiation to the line." Lumberjack was very puzzled. The idea of an initiation seemed far from ordinary, but he didn't mind. He agreed to their terms wholeheartedly. If the steam engines knew what was going on, Rockstar certainly would have put a stop to it, but they never found out. The diesels were very pleased that their plan was working. Later that evening, Lumberjack puffed into the yard, where all the diesels were waiting for him. "Welcome, my friend," bellowed Seth, "to the initiation. Here, you will tackle the nearly impossible, somewhat improbable, actually quite nearly, it's pretty difficult actually, but here, you will pull the longest train ever pulled, devised of what we could find in the entire freight yard. If you can pull it, we will consider you one of us." "We are not a cult!" "Oh, sorry." Lumberjack, not realizing what he was getting himself into, reversed so he could turn around and find a turntable, and thus couple to the train. Then Hobbs left so he could watch. The diesels waited impatiently in the yard for Lumberjack to return from the turntable and begin the initiation. Little did they know, however, as he backed onto the train, he was more than capable of pulling it.